fuel cell, we have already seen improvement refined for many uses, especially for some taxonomic assessment. And we have seen other tools like the iPlant, taxonomic resolution, engineering, and also. But all of these require a certain level of misspelling free and error free taxonomic names. So we're going to use now this short, really short brief demo, how to use Google Refine to detect and correct misspellings in taxonomic names. So here we have a little list of 10 records which have these cover marker here. This says name complete. So we have this column here, which is called name complete. We're going to use that for the demo. We should be using taxonomy, but this time we're going to use name complete. So Google Refine has this good feature, which are facets. Facets. So you go to the list of the in the column, like just the same way you're going to do a text filter. The first entry is the facet. So we click on facet and we select text facet because the data we have is text. Then we will define automatically the text of the different ways, of the different names that appear in the column. And in fact, besides each name, there's a little number. It's the number of times that particular version of the name appears. So for example, we'll focus on the last two, Tapis Japonica and Tapis Japonica. The first one, Tapis Japonica, appears 6 times, while Tapis Japonica appears just once. We might deduce then that Tapis Japonica is a misspelling, that the trailing double A is in fact a typo, something that shouldn't be there. And if we click then on edit, we can manually correct that. And apply, and it's gone. Now we have 7 records with Tapis Japonica. Now, if we take a look at the other names, we have Amelia divagans, first time with a capital D, and the second and third times the name appears look similar. In fact, they look exactly the same. So why does Google Refine detect them as different if they are the same? So we cannot edit them. And if we see here, there is an extra space at the end of the name. So it's not just Amelia divagans, it's Amelia divagans and the space. So we can clear, we can remove that space, apply it, and then we will find the text that the name sounds. So that's another typo we are correcting that we will define. But there's another way, easier and faster. This is easy because we have very few different names. But if we have lots of names, going one by one can be a bit overwhelming. So there's another way to do this faster, and it's the cluster button. You click on the cluster button, it tries to detect which of the different versions of the same name can be put together, which ones are slight modifications of the same basic name. So here it only detects that there are 2 rows with Amelia divagans with small d, and 1 row with Amelia divagans with capital D. So Google Refine says, maybe these 2 are the same, and you have a problem with 1 of them. The thing is, Google Refine doesn't know which one's right and which one's wrong. That's our job. So we say, yes, we want to merge those 2 names, and we want the final name to be Amelia divagans, with which one? With capital D or with lower D? With small d, because it's a species element. So we'll detect that. So cluster size is 2 because there are 2 names. The row count is 3 because there are 3 rows that will be affected. And now that we have everything ready, we can merge selected, and if we would like to rerun a cluster with different names, we will see merge selected and recluster. If not, we can just say merge selected and jobs. So we have made clear mates and merge selected and recluster, and now the refine says, okay, there's nothing left for me to try and cluster, try and move. So we can close it. And now we can see that the different values for name complete are just three records for Amerati values of the same, without joining spaces, without capital letters in specific epithets, and seven records of tables level. It's a really cool, fast, and efficient way to work with taxonomy principles. And it's something you're going to do in the next